Hi, I'm Laura from Delphi. Every driver hates it when an oncoming vehicle dazzles them with their headlights. That's a clear sign that the alignment isn't right. So today I'm going to show the correct way to align the headlights on this 2016 Audi A3 e-tron so that they give good illumination, but most importantly are safe and comply with the law. Just a quick note before we start. I'll be calibrating the alignment on a right-hand drive vehicle. For a left-hand drive vehicle, simply flip the process. Okay, let's get started. Headlights at the low beam setting don't produce a circular beam of light like an inspection lamp or a torch. Instead, the lens and reflectors create a beam pattern that is flat on top. This is to give the maximum illumination of the road without dazzling oncoming drivers. A right-hand drive car usually will not have oncoming traffic approaching from the left. So the beam pattern kicks up at the left to better illuminate the curb, verge, pedestrians, or vehicles joining the road from the left. The beam should be pointed down slightly so that it produces a pool of light on the road ahead. The angle is shown here as a percentage. 0% would be the light projected out horizontally, so you'll never see that figure. The figure here is 1%. That means for 10 meters away from the headlamp, the light falls by 1% every meter. 1% over 10 meters represents 10 centimeters. Let's have a look at how to set the alignment of this lamp. Before I start, I have to check a few things that will affect our measurement. The car and aligner should be on a flat and level surface. The ride height of the car at each wheel should be even and within the manufacturer's specification. The tyres should be inflated to the correct pressure. You may need to use a 75 kilogram load to simulate the weight of a driver. This is the beam setter or aligner. We need to make sure that it's parallel to the vehicle using the alignment window and the correct distance from the headlight lens. I now roll it to the center line of the car and look through the alignment mirror. There are also aligners with laser measuring devices that achieve the same thing. Now, I need to make sure the aligner is at the correct height and in the center of the headlamp lens. Just follow the aligner's instructions for this. This Audi has static LED headlights, not the later type of matrix lights common on many newer vehicles. Before adjusting, we need to place the headlights in adjustment mode using the DS Diagnostics tool. Today, we're using the DS480. Connect to the vehicle and access the headlight controller. Run the function, adjust light setting. The headlights will now move into the adjustment position. With the headlamps on, I now look into the aligner and check the pattern on the internal screen. There should be no white light above the 0.5% line and to the right of the 0% vertical line. This would dazzle an oncoming driver. The horizontal cutoff of the beam should be on or slightly below the horizontal line for the percentage marked on the lamp. In this case, 1%. The kick up should be to the left of the 0% line. If you need to alter the aim of the lamp, turn the adjuster here for vertical and here for horizontal. The exception to what we've done here today is if the vehicle is fitted with hydraulic or air suspension or has adaptive lighting. Thanks for watching. If you want to see more videos, then be sure to follow us on social media or visit the Masters of Motion online hub. And for more expert-led courses, then why not check out the Delphi Academy? See you next time.